I wanted to talk broadly about audio, and you have a very a considerable background in terrestrial radio, and things have changed so much over the years. I wanted to ask about, how you define audio broadly now and its opportunities for marketers, and particularly for, your clients in the automotive space.
Yeah, so audio has become sort of a catch-all phrase for anything that you can listen to. And yes, you're right. I spent 20 plus years in the traditional radio space, and I got to understand the power of audio well before the advent of digital. And look, there are key differences today from a broadcast radio perspective and from a streaming audio perspective. And it really starts with traditional radio is still set up in a one-to-many marketing scenario. And that works for many, many, many brands. On the streaming audio side, though, this is where it really gets into personalization. It really gets into one-to-one relationships at scale. It really starts to open up all of the data opportunities that exist in digital, but that can then be portrayed in this streaming audio environment. And it's unlocking enormous opportunities for all categories of business, but specifically for us and for our clients in the automotive space.
Could you just explain a little bit broadly about activations in the auto space? I mean, I don't know if you don't have to name clients, but just how does it work and why is it valued to automotive marketers?
Yeah, so the how it works part, let's start very, very simply. Audio has a terrific ability to create an emotional connection, right? And on the broadcast radio side, that historically was thought to be very, very upper funnel. And if you were looking to reach in market, you had to cast a really, really broad net. And the way that dealers are activating streaming audio now is you're able to ascertain through data who are the people that you would like to speak with the most. And you can utilize third-party data providers. You can utilize companies like TruOptik and their DMP, where they have terrific aggregated audiences. But the beauty of streaming audio is you can build your audience first. And then through profile matching, you can then go find those audience members wherever they may be consuming streaming audio, whether that be music, whether that be podcasting, whether that be on Spotify, Pandora, the iHeartRadio apps, or through the Triton SSP and their supply side partners.
I wanted to ask, how this new world of data and audio allows marketers to reach the folks they want in a way that's different from what radio, and talk a little bit about the data sources, the data sets, and sort of the results that you can get.
Well, the biggest difference that I see in the streaming audio space is you can decide on the audience that you would like to target first. Historically, advertisers have had to buy the publisher's audience in totality in order to search for their consumers. Today, through multiple data partners, and you can use companies like TruOptik and their DMP, which we use readily. And you can take these audience segments, and then through profile matching, you can then go find these people across the streaming audio ecosystem wherever they may be consuming content, whether that's their favorite podcast, whether it's a, family story time that they listen to on their Alexa, whether it's curated playlist. And you're able to create this terrific sonic experience, but you're only spending money on that sonic experience based on the data segment that you have created that is the best fit for your business. And for us in automotive, that is very, very specific. And streaming audio has opened up a plethora of opportunities, one, to create an emotional connection, but also to really reach lower funnel, ready to buy consumers. And you're able to have two conversations at once, like, why should you do business with this dealership? Because audio can make you feel something. But also have that conversation with them, you know, as they're moving through the funnel on the lower end. And that's been a real game changer in the space for many of our clients.
So are you comfortable or satisfied with the sort of attribution tools around this? Or is performance clear? Is performance, you know, different maybe than what traditional audio had been? Where does that stand?
Yeah, so this is a really aggressive frontier, right? And KPIs that matter, attribution that you can count on, is a massive conversation. And first, let me start with sort of how we approach this. And we have been able over the last several years to create a tech stack, both with outsourced technology companies, and think about companies like Factual that power the logistics for Amazon, where with the phone in the pocket, we are able to understand if from a curated audience that we run a streaming audio campaign on, we're able to tell if that device actually walks in to a dealer showroom. So for us in the last year, it's gotten well past KPIs like cost per thousand, completed listens. And now it is really about what percentage of this audience that we built were we able to actually get to walk into your showroom or into your service department. And that's allowed us exceptional optimization opportunities, because historically, streaming audio or connected TV campaigns have really been optimized around one thing, and that is, do I hit the CPM that was agreed upon? And we're big believers that not all CPMs are created equal, and a cheaper CPM doesn't necessarily mean success. But if we're able to build a campaign for a dealer that spends X amount of dollars and they are able to get X amount of visits for $50, $60, $70, $80 per visit, well, that's a different conversation. And now the strategy conversation sounds like this. If we make these optimizations to this campaign, we believe we can get more people into your dealership for less money per visit than we have historically been able to do. So it's making this a much more horizontal conversation around KPIs that are much closer to the purchase. And that's what we think matters the most, specifically in the automotive space.